Hello and welcome to the session on Instructional Media in Social Studies. Advancements and refinements continue to be made in instructional technology. Instructional systems that include lesson formats, books, films, slides and other media are being produced for a variety of units and courses. Education television and videotapes of selected programs, films produced by TV networks and TV equipment for use in the classroom are very useful in many units of instruction in social studies. Computerized programs of instruction have been tried out in many classrooms and instructional media centers now provide a variety of services ranging from collection and distribution of materials to the actual handling of classroom projects by remote control. Audiovisual aids are viewed as an integral part of a teaching system. What are the basic guidelines for using instructional media in social studies? Instructional media of all types should be viewed as sources of data. Instructional media should be used to achieve specific objectives. The classroom should be viewed as a laboratory. A multimedia approach to the use of instructional materials promotes learning. Materials of instruction should be evaluated before, during, and after use. What are the criteria for selecting instructional aids? Some criteria are necessary for the selection of instructional aids in social studies teaching. They are purpose, variety, appropriateness to the maturity of children, content, physical qualities, manuals, time, effort, expense, and selection of free or inexpensive materials. Instructional aids in social studies teaching. Because multimedia approaches to instruction have demonstrated their value, teachers have an obligation to identify and use a variety of media. Sensory experiences form the foundation for intellectual activity. Sensory aids affect on economy of time in learning. The number of aids for instruction has become so numerous that today a teacher of any subject need not resort to any of the archaic methods of teaching. Even the most abstract concept can now be presented to the pupils in a concrete way by means of more than one aid. Educationists categorize the concept of educational technology into two approaches, hardware and software approaches. The hardware approach is based on the application of engineering principles for developing electromechanical equipments for instructional purposes. Projectors, tape recorders, computers, etc. are called educational hardware. Hardware approach mechanizes the process of teaching. The software approach uses the principle of psychology for building the learner a complex repertory of knowledge or modifying his behavior. Newspapers, books, magazines, flashcards, etc. may also form part of software. System analysis and design of instruction is the underlying basic factors in the development of instructional aids. It has been recognized that students grasp ideas better to concrete aids like pictures, charts, graphs, practical works, field trips and the like. Further, to meet individual differences in classrooms, the teacher must resort various types of aids that appeal to the different senses. Even among aids, there are quite a lot of them which appeal to two or more senses simultaneously. Instructional aids play a key role in teaching learning situations. It works as the support to both teacher and the taught in the pursuit of knowledge and curriculum transaction. Teaching aids are the tools purposefully designed to overcome verbal deficiencies in communication in a classroom situation. Teaching aids are divided into different types as per their natural function and usability. Why we use instructional media in instruction? As a rule, educational experiences that involve the learner physically and that give concrete examples are retained longer than abstract experiences such as listening to a lecture. Instructional media help to add elements of reality for instance, including pictures or highly involved computer simulations in a lecture. Media can be used to support one or more of the following instructional activities. First one, gain attention. A picture on the screen, a question on the board, or music playing as students enter the room all serve to get the students' attention. For recalling prerequisites, use media to help students recall what they learned in the last class so that new material can be attached to and build upon it. For presenting objectives to the learners, hand out or project the day's learning objectives. For presenting new content, not only can media help make new content more memorable, media can also help deliver new content, for example, a text, movie or video. Support learning through examples and visual elaboration. One of the biggest advantages of media is to bring the world into the classroom when it is not possible to take the student into the world. Elicit student response. For presenting information to students and pose questions to them, getting them involved in answering the questions too. For providing feedback, media can be used to provide feedback relating to a test or class exercise. For enhancing retention and transfer, pictures enhance retention. Instructional media help students visualize a lesson or transfer abstract concepts into concrete, and it is easier to remember objects. For assessing performance, media is an excellent way to pose assessment questions for the class to answer, or students can submit mediated presentations as classroom projects. The major graphic aids that are used effectively in social studies teaching are given in the following sections. Charts. Charts are illustrative and reinforcing instructional tools. They can be used as displays such as bulletin boards, but probably they are best suited for getting across points in specific lessons. It may be defined as a combination of graphic and pictorial media designed for the orderly and logical visualizing of relationship between key facts and ideas. What are the important types of charts? There are different types of charts like narrative charts, tabulation charts, pedigree charts, classification charts, organization charts, flow charts, and timeline charts. What are the purpose of charts? Charts are useful for showing relationship between facts, for presenting material symbolically, and for summarizing information. Maps. Maps are flat representation of the Earth's surface, which convey information by means of lines, symbols, words, and colors. They are universally accepted symbol for representing space. Types of maps. There are different types of maps, for example, political maps, physical maps, climate maps, population maps, economic maps, etc. Elements of maps. The maps consist of the title, symbols, the scale, direction, grid system, and latitude and longitude. Purpose of maps. There are number of purposes for using maps: to show locations, to show size, shape, distances and area, to show slope and elevation, to give a picture of places, and to illustrate the effects of events. Map reading skills. Map reading skills mainly include direction skill, scale skill, and location skill. There are certain guidelines for map making. First of all, have a single specific purpose for a map. Avoid too much detail. Make the map as accurate as you can and state the purpose clearly in the title. How can we effectively use the maps? Maps can be used in social studies class effectively in the following ways. Maps should not be overcrowded. Involve pupils in preparation. Use more outline maps and develop content as lesson proceeds. Graphs. Graphs are visual presentation of data. In the early grades, they are used to show such information as daily temperature, enrollment, attendance, books read, and other items familiar to children. In later grades, they are used to show population growth, resources, exports, and other items originally organized in tables. In all classes, the interpretation and construction of graph must be related to instruction in the mathematics program. The application of mathematical skills to social studies content enriches learning in both programs. Line graph, bar graph, pictorial graph, and pie graph are the different types of graphical representations. The nature of variation to dependent qualities could be very easily presented by graphical representation. Interpreting graphs is very easy and quick. Correct inferences could be drawn with ease. Pictographs are graphical representation which use simplified representational figures. Timelines. Time charts and timelines are used to clarify time relationship, to relate events to major time periods, and to relate events in one country to those in another. In the elementary classes, charts may be made to show events of the day, major events during the week, events related to the growth of community, changes in transportation, changes in farming, and changing ways of providing food, shelter, and clothing. In secondary classes, charts and timelines may be used to show events during major periods of history of the state or nation, the development of transportation and communication, and the like. Children should be guided to develop a time base or frame of reference for interpreting time periods and time relationships. In all grades, units of time that students understand, a meaningful theme for selecting events to include on time charts, and an appropriate and accurate scale are emphasized. Pictures. The photographs and illustrations in textbooks and other reading materials add interest and help to clarify difficult terms and understanding. Postcards, cutouts from magazines and newspapers, and other pictures are used to achieve a variety of instructional objectives. Pictures can make children reports and scrapbooks more meaningful. When several pictures are shown, students may compare and contrast items, identify a sequence of processes or action, and evaluate what is shown and how well it is portrayed. Now we are moving to cartoons. Cartoons are designed to convey an idea by means of caricature, humor, stereotype, oversimplification, exaggeration, and satire. Sun symbols use Angul Sam, the dove of peace may be used. The meaning of the symbols must be clear, and understanding of the situation, issue, or problem must be developed if students are to interpret cartoons. When cartoons are encountered in reading and other materials, they must be analyzed to help students understand symbols used, the situation or problem portrayed, and the purpose of the cartoonist. Posters. Posters convey single idea in a way that can be grasped at a glance. They are used to sway people to a course of action and are often used in campaigns for safety, energy conservation, or other topics of concern. Space, line, form, and color directs attention to desired action, making posters acquaint students with a way of presenting a single idea simply and forcefully. The following are the major display boards used in social studies instruction. The bulletin board. Bulletin board is useful in initiating units, stimulating new interest, clarifying problems, posting children's work, and displaying materials. In initiating units, display materials that evoke interest and stimulate questions about those topics that come first in the unit. By changing and rearranging to stimulate new interest, the development of the units can be guided in sound directions. The bulletin board, as the name implies, is place for bulletins, news items, announcements, multifarious items, and visual displays that are of absorbing interest to the students. It can present dramatic evidence of the nature of people and teacher activities. Another aid is flannel board. Flannel board is also known as felt boards. It is especially helpful in presenting events or ideas in sequence as a story unfolds, a report is given, a demonstration is performed, steps in a process are given, or basic concepts are presented in definite order. It can also be used to the layout of a farm to experiment with different arrangements of items for a display or floor layout, to assemble jigsaw maps to show how a bill become a law, and to make circles and bar graphs. An outline map can be sketched on the flannel board and cutouts of areas used to show how territory was added. One of the main advantages of flannel board is their flexibility, which permits various arrangements to be tried experimentally. Another type of board is magnetic board. In its uses, the magnetic board is similar to the flannel board. Small magnets are attached to objects, pictures, maps, cutouts, and other items to hold them to the thin iron sheeting used to make the board. The magnetic board is used primarily to demonstrate key concepts, although it may occasionally be used as a bulletin board. Some schools have installed magnetic chalkboards which serve the same purpose. Pegboards. Pegboards can be used for combining flat and three-dimensional materials, the latter being supported by specially made hooks and clips. Display can also be positioned at desired place by pegs. Pegboards are made of tempered masonite having 1x8-inch holes punched in regular pattern of a 1-inch apart over the entire surface. Chalkboards. Chalkboard is a basic and versatile visual tool. Use it to list suggestions during group planning, sketch illustrations, list reading materials, note assignments, copy suggestions for charts, summarize a discussion, record group dictated stories or letters, and so on. Many teachers increase the effectiveness of chalkboard use by adding simple stick figures to illustrate points, using colored chalk to emphasize key ideas, and using rulers, compasses, and stencils to obtain neat artistic effects. Three-dimensional aids or 3D aids. It is not always possible to bring real objects in the classroom due to the reason that they may be too large or too small in size to be brought in the classroom. It may also be too dangerous and expensive for ordinary class use. In such situations, a teacher searches for some good substitute for the real objects which are three-dimensional in nature. These teaching aids have three dimensions: length, breadth, and height. Models, mock-ups, globes, diorama, puppets, and holograms are included under these three-dimensional aids. Models. A model is usually the miniature structure of the original object. They are the replicas or copies of the real objects. According to Edgar Dale, a model is a recognizable imitation of the real thing with an increase or decrease in size as the chief difference. Thus, they may be of the same size or large or smaller than the thing it represents. They simplify reality and are helpful to create interest in creative activity among peoples. They are generally of three types: solids, cross-sectional, and working models. Now, we are moving to mock-ups. It refers to a specialized model or working replica of the object being depicted. In a mock-up, a certain element of the original reality is emphasized or highlighted to make it more meaningful for the purpose of instruction. A model is a recognizable imitation of an object, while a mock-up may or may not be similar in appearance. These are often used in technical institutions for training purposes. Globe. You are very familiar with globe. A globe is the three-dimensional representation of the surface of the earth on a very small scale. It is a round shaped wooden or plastic model of earth. According to McKinney, globe is the most direct and versatile instrument of mathematical analysis. Its language is of color and symbols. It is used for teaching history and geography to the students. It provides us information about areas, distances, directions, time location, symbols, colors, boundaries, rivers, change in weather, season, day and night, etc. Diorama. A diorama is a three-dimensional scene in depth incorporating a group of modeled objects and figures in a natural setting. The diorama scene is set up on a small stage with a group of modeled objects kept on the foreground, which is blended into a painted realistic background. They are very effective in the teaching of biological and social sciences. Holograms. Holograms are three-dimensional images of wonderful reality. These images are created on a holographic, namely lensless photography plate without a camera. They are less frequently used in schools, as preparing them requires lot of technical skills as well as equipment. What is the education significance of 3D instructional aids? 3D teaching aids motivate the students and make them to learn things interestingly. They are used for teaching different concepts like areas, distances, boundaries, rivers, time, weather, seasonal changes, the motion of earth, etc. They are helpful in technical education for training purposes, especially in engineering field. They concretize abstract concepts. They are used to dramatize any historical event like war, life of people during a particular period, and thus give a actual experience to peoples. They are helpful for developing creative power among students. They involves the principle of learning by doing or acting by involving students in preparation of models, dioramas, mock-ups, etc., which provides first-hand experience to the students, and they can be used for a wide range of instructional situations. Let us summarize what we have discussed so far. Instructional media are very helpful in obtaining the active involvement and participation of the learners in the teaching learning process. They quicken the interest of the learners and motivate them to learn. Instructional systems that include lesson formats, books, films, slides, and other media are being produced for a variety of units and courses. The major graphic aids that are used effectively in social studies teaching are charts, maps, graphs, timelines, pictures, cartoons, and posters. The major display boards used in social studies instruction are the bulletin board, flannel board, magnetic board, peg boards, and chalk boards. When it is not possible to bring real objects in the classroom, teacher searches for some good substitute for the real objects which are three-dimensional in nature. They are models, mock-ups, globes, diorama, puppets, and holograms. Now, you can try to answer the questions given here. What are the criteria for selecting instructional aids? What are the different types of charts? How map different from globe? When and how pegboards used in social studies teaching? Enlist the educational significance of 3D instructional aids. Now, you may go through the reference books listed here. Social Studies in the Classroom, Trends and Methods, written by Kumar PKS and Naushad PP and published by Scorpio Publishers Calicut in the year 2006. Teaching of Social Sciences, written by Rohela SP and published by Nilkamal Publications, Hyderabad in 2009. Educational Technology, written by Kumar KL and published by New Age International Private Limited, New Delhi in 1996. The Teaching of Social Studies, written by Kochar SK and published by Sterling Publishers Private Limited, New Delhi in 2003. Instruction Technology, written by Thamarishiri I and Pari MA and published by APH Publishing Corporation, New Delhi in 2014. Thank you for watching this program. We can meet again with another topic. Have a nice day.